Hello, good morning, viewers. I am Bhujradeep Das, an assistant professor of an engineering college, and I am also a structural engineer. So today is my sum on precast concrete theme. It is a chapter from pre-stressed concrete. And for at the beginning, I have already provided you the question. Now we start from given data. Is equal to P by A. Is equal to P is given 150 kilonewton 2 into 150 into 10 to the power cube divided by 20 into 10 to the power cube equal to 15 newton per meter square. Now, loss is equal to 15%. So, we have to find out effective pressure after loss. Now, we know the self-weight of precast beam, self-weight of precast beam is equal to 0.1 into 0.2 into 24 into 10 to the power cube. 24 into 10 to the power cube newton per millimeter cube. It is the unit weight of concrete. Is equal to 480 newton per meter. So we will denote it W. So self weight of moment of precast beam is equal to W into A square by H L is equal to span is equal to 5 meter. W is equal to 480. 480 into 5 square divided by 8 is equal to 1500 newton meter. Top and bottom so we can find out stress at top and bottom through movement divided by section modulus. So movement is equal to 1500 as it will convert it to CGS unit, so 10 cube will be added, 10 cube will be multiplied divided by 667 into 10 cube. is equal to plus minus 2.25 newton plus pi per millimeter. Now we have to go for fetch. Now the beam part have already done. So we have to find out the stress of fringe. So self weight of fringe is equal to say 0.4 into 0.04 into 24 into 10 cube. Is equal to 1200 newton. From here we have to find out self weight moment of flange. So that is, if we take it W1, the self weight of flange, then M1 will be the moment, self weight moment, then W1 into W1 into L square divided by H. So W1 is 1200 into 5 square divided by. So it will be plus minus 1.8 newton per meter. Now I will not find the moment of inertia and center of gravity CG from here. So firstly, from here y1 dash we will get 153 and y2 dash is equal to 87 through the process of moment of inertia and center of gravity phi, and ixx is equal to 197 into 10 to the power 6 millimeter to the power 4. Now we have to find out life load of composite section. So life load of composite section life load is composite section is mentioned that 8 kilonewton per meter. So from this the life load act will be act here. So from this we will get 0.4 into 0.04 into 8 kilonewton means 8000 newton is equal to kilonewton per meter. So we will take if the breadth is 400 mm and length is 1 meter as, so it will be 0.4 into 1 into 8000 newton. So it will be 3200 newton meter. Now we have to find out life load movement. So life load movement is same as W L square by H. Here W is equal to 3200 into 5 square divided by H. So it will be 10,000 newton meter. Now we have to find out stress developed due to life load. That will be sigma t and sigma e. So sigma t and what will be the formula or what will be the measurement of sigma b and sigma t? It will be m by zt and m by zt. Zb, zt is equal to ixx divided by 87, that is y1. Zb is equal to ixx divided by 153, that is y1 dash and y2 dash. So we can get the zt and zp value. So from here sigma t is equal to into 10 cube divided by the ZT value will be 226 into 10 to the power 4. So sigma t is equal to 442 newton per millimeter square. And Z similarly ZB equal to 10,000 into 10 cube divided by ZB, that is 128 into 10 to the power 4 is equal to 781 newton per millimeter. I hope you can understand, and thank you for watching my video.